Yeah. So from the center of e-learning,
plan that we have put in place, if every one of you put on strike, don't move, don't respond, then of course the benefit will go to the student. So our hope, you know, is that after this very short session with you, you know what is PEP doing, and you get excited as Dr. Chandler and all of us, okay? For the sake of the way to move forward, okay, using technology. Move on. You. Now, this is the DEPAN version 2.0. DEPAN here refers to the e-learning policy of Malaysia. So this one supports the education blueprint. And through the years, the blended learning KPI have been given. Okay, so we have been exceeding it all the time. Here, for this time, it is 50%. Okay. PPIB have been doing very well, isn't it? Congratulations. Very learning. Okay. So, because you have done in such a platinum, isn't it?
No.
Okay, so this year should be platinum. With Eugenia around, you will get platinum. Okay. Move on. So, what is blended learning? What is blended learning? Can somebody be bold enough to just say, what is blended learning to you?
Interaction.
Okay, there you are. What do you think is blended learning? Yeah, the use of technology is true. Okay, let's have a look. Many people respond, blended learning in UMS is concerning achieving 1732.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes, because this is for auditing purposes. It comes actually from the Kementerian, this formula. But in reality, this is there's a misconception over here. Okay? People who feel this and they feel that no blended learning have been achieved. Is it so? So blended learning is defined as a mixture of face-to-face and non-face-to-face interaction. Eugenia gives the correct term. Okay? This term must be there. Interaction. So how can we have interaction face-to-face? How can we have interaction even in the virtual environment? So this is where Dr. Kenneth will be showing you concerning certain tools that are so easy to use that can increase interaction, increase engagement, increase meaningful learning among our students. Move on. This particular book is available online. You just Google back to blended learning, then you will go to this particular URL. This type back to this. It is produced by Commonwealth Learning, it's 2018. So the theory behind blended learning, the different approaches, the different model behind blended learning is all in this book. Available, open source, open license. Okay, move on. So, dear fellow colleagues, our challenge, our shaban, okay, is going beyond this 1732. Okay, move on. And this is where smart TV, smart version 3 comes in. We have smart version 2. People are comfortable there, okay? But we have to move out from that comfort zone into something focused new. Okay, so that's where Dr. Kenneth will orientate us, okay, to the interface of version 3. And this will support better quality of education in blended learning in UMS. Move on. Our challenge, dear friends, our challenge is to create interactive and engaging blended learning activities. Face to face, a lot of different approaches used by all of us because we have we are in different discipline, we have different approaches that you feel is more appropriate. Okay, so they are interactive, they are engaging. Now, what about this one? Are we just only putting a PowerPoint there and let them download? Okay, so we want engaging and interactive features here. And that is what we really want to share in, okay, in smart. Of course, this guide all our courses, okay, the Bloom Taxonomy, from lower order thinking to higher order thinking. We want our students now to be here, finally able to create new and original work, able to construct, develop, come up even with an invention. So which means that you need to bring them, bring out their creativity. Can we do it online? Could technology enable them to support all this? So many of us here, you have been practicing many innovative ways, okay, and your students have benefited. Dear friends, next month there will be a promotion concerning a competition that is held by Pusat E Pembelajaran. So also, please be bold enough to participate, okay? And if you are selected, then you will be representing UMS in international competition. Is to do with technology-enabled learning and also pedagogy of teaching and learning. Your technology can be as simple as just a piece of paper and pencil, but it somehow is effective. You know what I mean? So be bold to share it. So we will be having this competition coming up. Okay, move on. Please participate. Conventional approach, we are here before our student. Maginina, this is conventional, okay? I'm the only one holding the mic. Everyone, yeah, you know, listen to me. Okay. Then at the same time, you will tell the student, do refer to some of the resources online. So this is conventional, move on. Just think for a moment. Would this be beneficial for your student? What if your instruction over here, what if your introduction of your concept be recorded, be pre-recorded, and it is made available online for the student, even before they come to the class? Okay, move on. So this is what that happened, the scenario. Now, your introduction of your concept or even your lecture pre-recorded is not made available, and the student, a few days before your lecture, they are already consuming in the comfort of their home, in the comfort of their own time, own pace. They can repeat, you know, students of different learning styles. And when they come back to the tutorial, when they come to the lecture, look, the whole scenario becomes different. So, deeper engagement, better questions from the student, okay? Group work, small group, big group, whatever pedagogical approach you want. Move on. So, this is an example of what we call as a flipped classroom. And flipped classroom is one of the models of blended learning. So you see, blended learning is not 1732, as you can see over here. So that particular book, please go to it, okay, and you can see the different models. This is one of them. Traditionally, lecture, and then we tell the students, these are your assignment, go back and do it. And when they go back and when they are attempting the assignment, that is where they scratch their head. They cannot apply. They don't know what to do. But nobody there to help them. What if they attend the lecture online, when they come to the classroom, the assignments are being done here in small group or big group or more interactive. Deeper dialogue is taking place. This is an example of blended learning. See? The use of technology, as you say, is true. And this can only take place if there's technology. See? It's not very available. The lecturer, you, could be in London or Sydney for your conference, but the student doesn't miss a class. They're still here. And then we have to order the tutorial. Okay, go on. So some of the benefits of blended learning we know, and that particular book, please go through it. Time saving, okay? Whatever that we have produced, we can use it again and again, you can update and upgrade it, okay? It's more engaging, you can use mobile devices. Almost every student are having a smartphone. So accessibility is there. It's flexible. Students, we have done survey and find that students prefer that more lecturers make use of technology to support their teaching and learning. And we know it is cost saving. It can be interactive. This is a challenge, of course. Okay? This is a challenge. So we have different tools that are very easy to use. The channel will lead us into this. Self-paced, self-access, self-directed, this is what we want, student-centered learning. Okay? And it can take place with technology-enabled blended learning. Move on. So, the Smart version 3, there is an e-book that is made available step-by-step. So, after, as the Dr. Kenneth show you the step-by-step, don't worry, if you miss it, you can just go back and look at the book here. Okay? Okay, go on. So, I would like to touch a little bit concerning OER. Now, how many of us here are familiar, you know, of producing OER? What is OER? Are you familiar? Are you familiar with OER? Online? Education, correct?
Resources.
Yes, resources. So, open education resources. Open education resources. Okay, move on. This is the repository. How How many of you have visited this repository, Rakesh? Have visited? Okay, we have 1, 2, 3. Okay, so today, please go and visit this place. This is specially built for you, for me, for all of us academic staff. This is a place where your materials goes distributed to the world. Move on. So, open education resources. Okay, move on. We move on. Move on. So, open education. Let me touch a little bit about this, because this will be very important for this year and for the years to come. How important is it? Just 3 months ago, exactly 3 months ago, UNESCO has already adopted something called recommendation of OER in higher education. So all governments throughout the whole world have received the resolution. So Malaysia, the time that our minister was there also during the adoption. Okay, move on. Now, in 2012, there's something called the Paris OER Declaration by UNESCO, okay? And when you say UNESCO, it means it goes to all the government in the world. It's the member states. Malaysia was one of them. And this declaration calls on government worldwide to openly license publicly funded educational materials for public use. Are you in this area, you know, where once you build something, once you have created something, it's copyrighted then, copyrighted to you personally. Okay. And if anybody wants to use your material, they ought to get permission from you before they use it. Okay? Before you use the materials and the graphic from the internet, you ought to, because you're all copyrighted, you ought to get permission. Do you do that? If not, we are infringing copyright already. So more often than not, you know, because of time or whatever or ignorance, we do not get permission first. We go ahead and use it. Okay. There is a way out. UNESCO is saying, you know, that how about you open licensing? Okay, move on. So everything in the internet is all copyrighted. Please be very careful. Whatever material you use, okay, if you prepare it and then you put it online, because we're helping you to put things online, okay? People who can come and sue us because we use the material without permission. And normally they won't sue you now. They wait until you become somebody. Okay. Some are public domain, which means you do not need any permission. Go ahead, use it freely. You don't even have to cite my name. Go ahead, use it. Because freely, public domain, they are. And in between, there's something called CC, open licensing called Creative Commons. Okay, move on. Creative Commons, okay, I am suddenly bringing you into the world of licensing. I'm bringing you into the world of your own hasil, you know, your own video, your own notes. You can copyright it straight away. You can license it, okay? And by using something called Creative Commons. You can Google later on, you know, and see what is this. All public universities in Malaysia are actually obliged to use CC. If you look at our smart UMS, down there, you can see actually CC license down there. All public universities use it. Just that it is not strongly and aggressively promoted. Okay, we are promoting it in UMS. So there are only four symbols, only four. I'm teaching you how to create license, you know. Okay, within minutes you know what to do. CC is very common. If it's a CC BY, it means whatever material you see under CC BY, you can use it without asking permission. Go ahead, use it freely. But you must attribute, you must cite where you get it from. Citation. Dear friends, this is what nowadays for Kenaikan Pangkat, the top management are looking for. Citation. You seen that, okay? So, for citation, many people say, you know, hey, get your journal, get your papers into high-impact journals, you know. But I'm asking you, how many people read high-impact journals? So, very low citation. If you, of course, you must do that, lah. High impact media journal, go ahead, it's very good, okay? But you need more than that to increase your citation. So go for open licensing. Okay? This is one of them. If you see this time, it means non-derivative. You are not allowed to modify anything here. If it's a photo, use it, but don't change the color. Example. Non-commercial, you see this, it means you can use it, but do not take the video and put it into your book and sell it. Okay, whatever. Non-commercialization. And share alike, it means you can go ahead, use my material, but make use of the same license, the CC. Okay, go on. So out of these four symbols, you come up with these licenses. It is the combination. And the one that is most free, of course, is CC0. It's the same as PD, public domain. Okay. And you have CC BY, okay? If you are more than willing to share your work, you know, and then people just attribute your name, okay? Freely, people can take it. And what can they do with this? They can retain it into their own computer, they can reuse it, they can revise it. Ladies and gentlemen, do you allow your work to be revised by people? Are you that open? Or can you allow that? Can you allow that? Of course, there are some materials you don't allow to be revised. For example, your poem. Can you allow people to remix your work? Redistribute? Okay. If you see materials that are all under this, it means you can actually apply all this. So you go to MIT, you go to Stanford, you get their lecture notes, you know, and then you remix it and become your own. Boleh tak? Boleh. Under CC, because they are under CC. Okay, provided they are under CC. So Dr. Kelly will be stressing to you concerning, you know, CC, look for CC materials. Then you won't get into trouble. When you go Google search, everything is copyrighted. But you pick, you know, under advanced there and put looking for CC materials, they will come up only CC materials. We use any of them, conscience free. Okay. So there you are. SA, NC, look at that. This is the one that in UMS, JTMP have used this. Huh? That means some materials people are not allowed to commercialize. Okay. So boleh-boleh, yeah? If possible, don't use this. Because if you should modify even a little bit, they can actually sue you. Okay? But all these are okay. So Dr. Kenneth might even show you places, you know, for example, in Pixar Bay or in Google search. Many of these things you use it freely for making your notes and so on. Okay, go on. The status quo. Everything is copyrighted. Are you bold enough to challenge the status quo? Move on. The one that first started challenging the status quo of copyright is MIT. In 2011, Massachusetts Institute of Technology, all their materials, all the syllabus, hey, even all the video, you know, all the lectures are available there. 2,400 courses. Immediately, even afterwards, you just go in, your course could be there. And look, the license they use. CC, BY, NC, and SA. That means, please, you can use any material from MIT, but please, use the same license. And do not commercialize our license. Don't make money out of it. Only for educational purposes. Okay? And remember to cite from where you got it. Okay, that's all they want. And they still maintain as one of the most high ranking of universities in the world. Okay. Let's move on. So just very briefly that, okay? There will be IDP courses on OER. So if you see this around, you know, you do register and come along. And then we will show you actually how to create courses by remixing materials and legally is licensed as your product. It's yours. Okay. But you cite from where the materials come from. Activities for, okay, so we're going to share with you some of the activities in Pusat E Pembelajaran. And all these activities are for every one of us here. So please participate. Move on. Example. MOOC. How many have produced MOOC here before? Up there. Then there were some. Okay. Anyway, MOOC, Massive Open Online Courses. They, are you familiar with MOOC?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. So, we are having a platform that is now test run by JTMK, and it will be ready very, very, very soon, okay, in the next few weeks. So, it's called MOOCIT, M-O-O-K-I-T. You can Google it, you can see it, okay? And there is a course at the moment, 4 weeks course, okay? Concerning the use of MOOCIT to develop MOOC. If you want to know the basic and the fundamentals of MOOC to the advanced level, go to this course. It's available now. So enroll. Okay. UMS and COL is our strategic partner of UMS. They'll be helping us. And somewhere in 2 months' time, there will be consultant coming from Commonwealth of Learning to share with us more concerning the MOOC. So, nobody asked what happened to the old platform. You don't know what happened to the old platform. We have an old platform. It's an open learning global. Okay? And what happened is that they say 5 years is free. But after about 2.5 years, suddenly they demand for money. And the money they ask for is quite substantial. If every one of us participate, you will come to $500,000. So we see here, TNCA say no way. So we go for alternative A, we develop our own one. Or different B, we get international platform. So finally we come to this. This MK has picked this. So we wait for this. Please get yourself enrolled, and in the meantime, you will be developing a lot of this. Especially from here, PIP. And your book will be available to the world. And once again, it will increase the visibility of the talent of your UMS. Increase your citation, increase your visibility. Okay, go on. Competition. This is what I'm saying just now. Okay? So last year, 2019, it was just somewhere in July, isn't it? Just a few months ago. Okay? So we have competition locally. You have a familiar face around here? Okay. So she can become the consultant. Okay? We share with them how we go about doing this. Locally in UMS, okay, there will be an announcement coming up very soon. Okay, Dr. Kelly will be putting up an announcement. And you have your own style of teaching and learning, you know. Do not belittle it. Get yourself participate in it. And you teach your way that you feel is most effective. If you are selected, you represent UMS. Okay? So this year, this International University Carnival will be in Terengganu. So we are yet to pick anybody. All of you, it's open to all of you. Okay? You can do in work in groups. Okay. Can tell you more also. Okay, move on. The Masteris Anugerah E-Learning, last year it was in the hotel in Wan Borneo. So you can see that Prof. TNC is here, and this one is Dr. Wan Johannes, the pengarah for the excellent academic division. And your some of your faces are here. Okay. So this Masteris is for who? For all of us. So do participate, you know, and do get involved, and you and your face will be here for this year. Okay. All this actually is dihargakan, you know, recognized by the university. Okay. The university have got a very special priority for e-learning. So get yourself involved with technology-enabled learning. Okay. Get yourself involved with PEP, any ideas you feel is right, you know, for your course, and it is not available, do come and contact the Center for E-Learning. Our doors are open, it's never locked, it's all the time open. And we have a new place, it is in Bangunan, FKJ Engineering. We just moved there exactly 1 month ago. Level 5, okay? Any one of you with any ideas, please come, because you have the experience, you have your own network, and you feel you're lacking in certain ways, please come, share with us, we move forward together. And you'll be a champion in that area, you take the lead in that area, we will support you. Okay. Go on. Some activities for students, I'm going to end soon. Move on. So for example, this is C Delta, Commonwealth Digital Education Leadership Training in Action. And this is online 100% by MOOC also. And it is to highlight your digital identity and to increase your global marketability. At the moment, we are working with alumni. The center is called Dr. Lai. Dr. Lai Media Center. So the alumni who are unemployed, they are taking this course as part of the upskilling. And how important is this? I think again, I will leave it to Dr. Keller, okay? This here, we will be looking for also champions who will be trained as mentors for C Delta. So in about a month's time, there will be an international consultant coming to train some mentors. So those of you who are passionate, you know, considering technology and enabled learning, do make yourself known to us, okay, through Virginia. And you could be a mentor here also, international mentor. Okay, move on. We have also this ebook. Okay? And this is our website, by the way, Center for E-Learning. So there is a publication over here. You click it, you can download all this ebook. So these are for our students. Okay, with respect to smart retreat and perpustakaan, JTMK were involved in producing this ebook. It's a standalone for our students.